the Florida legislature has refused to accept $50 billion in federal funds to expand medical coverage for an estimated 800,000 Floridians who fall in the health care coverage gap. As a result, the following people who fall in the gap have been condemned to die by the public. Coverage gap execution. Maria, single mom, has a small daughter who is covered by kid care. Maria works full-time as a home health aide and earns about $12,000 a year. She makes too little money to afford insurance, but too much to qualify for Medicaid. Therefore, Maria falls in the gap. Does the condemned have final words?
Yes, instead of ensuring working parents and students and nearly a million other Floridians have access to health care they need, the legislature has created the Florida coverage gap by intentionally turning down critical federal funds to expand access.
Gail 805 is a busser at a restaurant in Miami Beach, where he makes $4.25 per hour, plus tips. When things are slow at the restaurant, which is often, Oscar is sent home. Gail is sent home. Gail falls in the Medicaid gap and is hereby condemned to die. Does the condemned have any final words?
There are no more jobs out there for me. It is not my fault the companies are outsourced overseas. The good jobs are gone. I want coverage. I need coverage. I want to live too.
Marissa, too sick to work, suffers from a rare disease that is not recognized by the medical industry. So she doesn't qualify for disability. She's unable to work. But at 29 years of age, she's too old to be covered by her parents' insurance. Unable to work, broke, and uncovered, Marissa is hereby sentenced to die. Does the condemned have any final words?
I am not alone. More than a third of Floridians ages 18 to 34 live in poverty. Accept the federal funds, please.
Marissa, too sick to work. David, too young to die, to retire, is 61 years of age, which makes him too young to retire. Finding unemployment has been challenging because of age discrimination and because of the poor economy. So he gets whatever temporary work he can to make ends meet. He doesn't make enough to afford coverage. He falls in the medical gap. He is here to die. Does the condemned have any final words?
Even though I am young, even though I look young, I'm old at heart. Even though this is just a place, the reality is I nor we will have insurance unless Medicaid expansion is passed.
Next, we have Rachel, not enough time. A part-time student and a part. Next, we have Rachel, not enough time, a part-time student and part-time cashier at a food court who is facing rapidly rising tuition costs, high rates of unemployment, and consequently, a tough time affording medical bills. Given that millennials end up in the emergency room more than any other age group except the elderly, this is a major concern for thousands of young Floridians. Rachel is here to die. Does the condemned have any parting words?
Six in ten young people are uninsured. We lie between the ages of 18 to 34, and most of us are college students. Keep us in school, keep us on the road to graduation, improved fiscal solvency, and most of all, keep us covered. We are not young and invisible. I stand for the college students.
Our next condemned is Sergeant Hogan, a military veteran and one of 41,200 veterans living in Florida without medical coverage. As a result of our legislator not accepting federal funds to close the health care gap, Sergeant Hogan is here to die. Does the condemned have anything to say?
There are 103,700 non-elderly veterans who lack health care insurance in Florida, which includes 41,200 who would qualify for Medicaid if the state expanded their program. I am one of them. I fought for this country, I fought for our rights, and they won't even give us our basic health care provisions.
Our next condemned is Lazarus Under the Bridge, a man who lives on a bridge and does not qualify for Medicaid because his children don't live with him. He makes too little for private health insurance, or ACA, and does not meet current Florida guidelines for Medicaid. He falls in the Medicaid gap and is therefore sentenced to die. Does the condemned have any final statements to make?
Even though I am homeless, I am a human being. I deserve health care.
Our next condemned is Chris UNI, who is a regular person, someone who might have a good job and private medical insurance or ACA. But Chris might have fallen ill and stopped working as a result. Or Chris might have had an accident and can no longer work. Chris UNI is one of the hundreds of thousands of people living in Florida who is but one of two steps away from financial disaster, from unemployment, from illness, from homelessness. Chris is your next door neighbor, your coworker, your relative, your friend, or even you. Chris, like hundreds of thousands of people living in the verge of calamity with no safety net whatsoever, is likely to fall inside the gap at any given moment. Therefore, why wait? Chris is hereby condemned to die. Does the condemned have anything to say?
Yes. Actually, I have something to say. I am not here to die. I am here to take a stand for everyone in my situation. I am here to speak for those who are no longer with us because they have no health care coverage, because they fall in the gap. I am here for all these people who have died today. I am here to speak on behalf of single parents, veterans, homeless people, disabled, all those who make too little to afford health care or too much to get Medicaid. I am here to ask you in the audience, to join me, to help me, to lobby with me, to make the call, to ask for health care coverage for all. Please, speak to your elected officials, make the calls, advocate, repeat after me, health care coverage for all.
Health care coverage for all.
Fill the health care gap.
Fill the health care gap.
No more death sentence.
No more death sentence.
Together.
Together.
We can.
We can.
We will be back.
No more. My God.